Hey guys, how are you doing? Welcome back. Welcome back to this little podcast. This is the Little Bean and Me podcast channel. I'm Kayleen and I'm your host. I am the principal fiber artist and yarn dyer behind Little Bean Loves Hand Painted Yarn, and I'm on as Little Bean Crochet on Etsy, so you can always find my information down below. Welcome back to all the returning viewers, and a very special welcome to any new viewers. We've had a substantial amount of new subscribers. We're broaching 500 subscribers, which is kind of mind-blowing. I wasn't sure like if I was gonna have that many subscribers. You know, I just do this for fun and to show off my yarn and to kind of share my inspiration with all of you guys. So thanks so much for coming and coming back and enjoying what you're seeing. So if you're looking for some crafty stuff, some knitting in progress, some pretty dyed yarns, then you're in the right place. It's a crazy time of year. It is a crazy time of year. Christmas is almost here. I am panicking. I have not done almost any Christmas shopping yet. We were sick before Thanksgiving, then Thanksgiving was here, and then I had big shop update after Thanksgiving, and now this week I'm doing another shop update. I've been busy with family events and catching up with all of that wonderful stuff before we're hosting Christmas here. So it's been chaotic, to say the least. So let's just get into everything. Hopefully I can get all of this in a reasonable time. I feel like I say this every episode, but my goal is always to keep this as short but as enjoyable as possible. But I have a lot of yarn to show you today, so we're gonna start with some works in progress, things that I've been doing, and then we'll just roll from there. So if you guys remember, last week I showed you this little sock set that I was working on, and it was the gradient minis. So I had this gradient, which is a 20 gram mini skein, and I was thinking about, holy crap, the light just totally changed from the last time I looked at the screen. Apologies for the light change. I don't know what to do. I film it. Oh, now we're bright and sunshine again. The sun must be going in and out of the clouds, so I apologize for any changing light. Not much I can do about it. So anyway, I had these mini skein gradients, and I'm sorry I couldn't put it in the shop right away because I wanted to knit it. So in my little bag, this is my bag from Sheena over at Casual Fashion Queen. I feel like I mention Sheena every week, but I love Sheena, so sorry, not sorry. So what I did was I caked up two of those mini skeins, so you can see them in there, I think. Let's see, there we are. So we have two little mini skein cakes, my emergency crochet hook, which I've had to use, and then here on my Addy Turbo Rockets are my socks. So this is the gradient. You can see the yarn is a little kinky. It's not as kinky as it would be coming from a sock blake, but it's still a bit kinky. I have not had a problem knitting with it. I thought I was going to, and I thought I might have to like skein it up and relax it, but I'm comfortable enough in my own knitting style that I'm able to knit. Wow, it's so bright now. The light is changing like crazy. So here we are. We are just about in this purple section of the gradient, so just coming out of the white into the light purple. And you can see here my stitches. I have pretty consistent tension, which is great, but I do have to say it looks a little wonky. I don't know if any of you guys watch the Yarn Hoarder podcast. The Yarn Hoarder podcast? The Yarn Hoarder podcast. She is absolutely sweet. I follow her on Instagram. I've been following her for a while, and I was so excited when she started. But she did a whole episode where she talked about sock blanks and like knitting up things that were pre-knit, like a pre-knit sock blank, and your stitches kind of come out a little wonky. I'm doing a vanilla sock, so it's very easy to see, and I say vanilla like it's just stockinette. It's very easy to see the wonkiness of the stitches, but I'm not worried about it because I know that these will block out. So this is the beginning of my socks. I had to put it down because, as you will see, oh, let me get close. as you'll see. See, right here, I had a little bit of a boo-boo. Now that's not a yarn over, that's a Kayleen knit an extra stitch in the space. So you can see it's attached there. So I put it down. I was very frustrated for a couple of reasons. I'm not a sock knitter, I'm a new sock knitter. I'm not entirely 100% full on, I'm into sock knitting. I'm enjoying it. But the problem that I have is that I've dropped some stitches in this, which is why I've had my emergency crochet hook at the ready. So let me see if I can find it. So I had to do some pickups here. You can see kind of where they are. See that bigger stitch? That's where I had missed a stitch. I had missed a stitch, and so I went back, and then over here on this sock, so it's on the changeover, so I think that was just my problem. Is like, I'm too excited, get to the end of the row, pull my needle, and like a stitch will just slip off the end. These are very slippery, which I like. So over here, okay, over here, you can see right here, this stitch is a little bit bigger than the rest. What happened was that I thought I had missed a stitch. So because the stitch was so big, I was like, oh, I think I dropped another stitch. So I just went to the end, pulled them out, and then took my crochet hook and knit all the way back to the top. And then I couldn't remember from which side I had taken the stitch from. So if I had taken it from the needle facing me or the needle away from me. And I'm counting and counting and counting and counting and counting. And every time I'm coming up with 30 and 30. This is 60 stitches. So I'm counting 30 stitches, 30 stitches, 30 stitches, 30 stitches. I'm like, there's no way that there are both 30 stitches. Well, there are, because I knit something extra. But anyway, I digress. Going on a tangent. I am enjoying these. I think I will try and knit as much as I can. What I'm going to do is take a cutout of my foot so that I know what I'm working with, because right now these are for me and I have not like measured my foot at all or whatever. So I'm doing cuff down, I'm going to measure my foot, and what I'm going to do is see how far I can knit on one 20 gram ball. And if I'm able to knit past the length of my foot or past where I would normally do a toe decrease, then I know I'll have enough for the remaining two gradients, and then I could decide how I want to use the rest of the gradients. So I think I'm doing pretty well. I'll at least go, you know, as far as I can, you know, I'm just exploring this. So I have the green for heels, toes, and cuffs. I think I did 11 or 12 rows for the cuff. I keep slouching. Stop slouching. I think I did 11 or 12 rows, just one by one ribbing for the cuff, and then I started on just the plain stockinette sock. Normally I'm a short sock person and I'm a snug sock person, but I don't want to make it too snug that it doesn't fit. So we'll see. The last sock I did was on size ones. They were the Rose City Rollers that I frogged. They were too baggy and they were 64 stitches. So I did 60 stitches and I'm hoping that makes up for it, because my gauge, I think, is, I can't even measure, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm getting around 4 inches per 60 stitches. I don't know what the math is on that. 4 into 60. Let's pull out the calculator, because mental math is just not my jam right now. 12 stitches. Yeah, 15. No, that's not right. That can't be right. 15 stitches per inch. This is a failure. 4 1/4. Oh, in 30. 4-ish inches for 30 stitches, not 60. Failure in math in my part. I've had a rough couple days, guys. I'm just gonna be honest with you. 7.5. So I have 7.5 stitches per inch-ish. So I think I'm on gauge for like a normal sock. Like, this isn't something crazy. Like, down here it was a little tighter because it was coming off the ribbing, so I'm measuring across here. I don't have a tape measure, that was a thumb measure. Anyway, I've had a rough week. It's been a stressful week with the kids. The holidays are here, the schedules are weird. You know, Cece's been really tough with her brother in terms of behavior and being kind of obstinate. And she's only like this with me because it's mom and mom's here and let's cause trouble. So anyway, that's my sock. Socks, they're coming along nicely and I'm very, very excited. So the other work in progress, this is something I started today. I'm a person who likes to do handmade gifts and really thoughtful gifts. I'm not just like, oh, I'm just gonna go buy you this thing from the dollar section at Target. like when I go into a gift, I am like 110% in. So today, I dropped Cecilia off at school. Oh, I should say, this is a gift for someone who may or may not watch this podcast. They're a new crocheter, so the person who I think might watch this podcast, who's like a really expert crocheter, these aren't for you. These are for someone else, so please don't say anything. I don't want to say who they're for. But I have been working on some ergonomic crochet hooks, just polymer clay, and I'm doing a certain theme, which I won't say because that will also give away who these are for. Will you just focus? Okay. So here's the hook. It's just made with polymer clay, hand extruded, so to speak. Just kind of hand manipulated, made to be an ergonomic shape. She crochets hand over. So this feels pretty comfortable. If I was a hand over, I mean, I'm a hooker in this way. So this wouldn't be comfortable for me, but I know she crochets like this. So this is for her. Just did blacks and reds for this one. Blended the bottom with some black and red. So this was one, so the, you know those 2 ounce blocks of clay? So this was 1/4 of a block, like this plus this little black stripe. And then this part of the handle and these red were another 1/4 of a block. So it was like half and half mixed together and then some very small scraps. So this was just about 1 ounce of clay. It has a good weight. It's pretty balanced. Like, it's kind of, you can see that it's not perfect. You can see that it's hand done, but I'm working to finish up the shape. I wanted to give it some texture and not leave any fingerprints, which has been an interesting venture to try and not leave fingerprints on this hook. But I'm very pleased with it. This took me about half an hour to kind of rough sculpt, and then maybe 15 minutes to kind of do some detailing and texture, you know, some final, you know, still wanting to look at, oh my god, this light is crazy. I am so sorry, you guys. This is unreal. So yeah, this is what I've been working on, and this is what I'll be working on tonight, because I'm done dying for the week. I can't die anymore. Good lord, I am just not, I'm in like the slouchiest mood. Anyway, so these are bringing me a bit of joy. I'm enjoying working on these. So I made it so it can stand up on its own. Yay, it stands. So it's flat on the bottom, so it'll stand up for her. And I got her a set of, I think, 6 or 7 boy hooks. So that's what I am sculpting on. So I have a whole bunch of colors. I think I have plenty of clay to work up these. I might make her some coordinating stitch markers if I have the time. But yeah, so that's what I've been working on in terms of crafting. Again, I'm just like, shake it out, Kayleen, jeez. Okay, so in terms of dyeing, I've had busy dye week. Hey guys, how are you doing today? Today is Wednesday, December 7th, the 7th, and I am just getting set in my kitchen right now to do some dyeing, so I thought I would show you a little bit of my setup and what's going to be happening today, the things that I'm working on. I always get questions about, like, how do you manage to stay home with 2 kids and still dye yarn and still knit and still do all these things? Well, it's nap time right now. It is 20 minutes past 11. Cece and Tucker were both fed some early lunch, and Tucker I just put up for nap. Cece's in the potty, and I've been setting up the kitchen when the kids were eating, so I'm getting ready to dye. As you can see, I have my various pans. So here's where I do my kettle dyeing. Here's where I do some low immersion kettle dyeing where I have very little water. This is usually my waste pan, or it's either my prep pan where I put the fibers, or it's where I put my dyed fibers once I have dyed them, and that's where I put them before I put them into the wash. And then here is my soaking yarn. So this yarn's been soaking for, I don't know, about 40 minutes or so. So I think it'll be fine to just dye up. And then I moved my little yarn station. So if you remember last podcast, I talked about the Christmas tree and that I had to move my little yarn station. So here's my Christmas tree. My yarn station used to be in this little corner here. Pardon the big mess, but that's where I usually film my podcast. And so my yarn station was there, and so then we moved it into the dining room in this corner. But today, since I'm going to be doing a lot of dyeing, some active dyeing where I have to hold yarn and dip yarn and paint yarn, but some passive dyeing where I can just put the stuff in the kettle and then just go at it. So I moved my little desk here. So you can see I'm watching some Woolen Vine, Kristen of the Woolen Vine podcast. I doubt she watches mine, but I'm watching her Vlogmas, which has been very entertaining to see a little behind the scenes of how she does things. So yeah, so this desk is where I do all of my dyeing prep work. So if I'm doing gradients, I'll have my little knitting machines set up on this desk where we have the clamps underneath. So I have the small Addy, the large Addy, I have a loops and threads machine, and then I have my Baller and Swift, where I use this to prep yarn and also to prep yarn to ship out. So if you ever requested a balling service, the balls, then I will ball it up on my Swift and Baller and then label and send it to you. So that's my little setup for today. So I'm hoping to get a little bit of footage that I can just zippity-doo through and share with you a little of my process. So you can see here, I've got my dyes out. Not all my dye fits into this container, by the way. This fits about 20, I use Dharma dyes. So this fits about 20 pots of Dharma, and I have 23. 23 colors that I use. I mostly use primaries. Like, I have my primary colors, and then I have some pre-mixed colors. It just depends on what I'm doing, but I do like to mix my own by using the primaries and then mixing my own colors. So yeah, so that's the setup I have. My storage right now is a little bit like half and half. So here's my spin dryer, which gets moved out. It's big king size. Can you hear Angry Birds? she's playing Angry Birds on the potty. So my spin dryer's here, and then my dye stuff is here, here, and here on these shelves. It's not ideal because I can't reach the top shelf. And then I'll show you this room. Oh no, my battery's gonna die. I'll show you this room. So this is where I've shown this before. This is the guest room. As you can see, we have lots of diaper boxes. And then here, is my undyed yarn, which you can see that I am slowly running out. But that's good. That's a good thing. That means I can sell some more and then buy some more and then dye some more. So isn't that lovely? But yeah, that room is an absolute SHIT show. So I'm gonna get to dyeing. Hopefully I can get some clips for you, and I will see you on the other side. don't think I said busy enough. So I've dyed up a couple more of these sock sets. So I have this blue gradient with a nice warm gray as an accent. So it's like a navy-ish gray into like this nice cooly blue into some more light gray. So we got a few colors in here. So this is the sock. So it'll go from light to dark or dark to light or whatever, and then have that as the coordinating heels, toes, cuffs. And then this one is one of my favorites that I've dyed also. You can't see here, but there are two huge diaper boxes full of yarn that I'm going to show you because life is yarn, right? Life is yarn. So then here's the other set that I've dyed. So this is a nice gray gradient, a gradient, so to speak, a gradient. And then here's the coordinating mini skein. So these are four gradient minis plus a 20 gram mini skein. Anyway, so I might just skein these up so that they're not in a cake with a lot of tension on them. And I don't want to leave them in this form because they're kind of like all over the place, like sneaky. So we'll see how that goes. So I have those two sets that I dyed this week. Then I have a bunch of colorways that I'm going to show you for shop update. But the other set that I wanted to show you is here, which is going to be a not so merry Christmas or not so happy holidays set. So these are going to be mini skeins. I haven't divided these up yet into minis form. So these are all on sparkle. I don't know if the lighting is, oh, there it goes. I was gonna say, I don't know if the lighting is conducive to showing sparkles today. So this is a more PG-13 type set. So I saw this comic, which I'll put a picture here, of like an eyeshadow palette for the holidays, and it's kind of like a parody type thing. So it's like winter solstice, blah blah blah, and then it's like twinkle twinkle little beep. Like, all I want for Christmas is money. You know, like all the different colors have these really sassy names. So I dyed up a set of mini skeins along those lines. So this one is Nasty Dirty Slush. So it's this gray tonal. This one is Twinkle Twinkle Little Bitch. Again, shield your ears if you don't care for swears, but I thought these were really funny. This one is Getting Wasted at the Company Holiday Party. So these are all on sparkle. This one is Bicurious, but only till February. And these are like the colors from the palette. So I took each color and like color matched and dyed it up. And this is a lovely kind of coral color. It's pulling a little more red on screen, but this is Old Saint Nicholas. So if you're a little grinchy, which I can be sometimes, this might be something you're interested in. But these were really fun to color match, so I took that palette and I played around with colors and mixed up some custom colors and got these. So very, very fun. So those will be not so jolly holiday mini skein set. So I have to break those up. Another thing for me to do today, yay! okay, so that's kind of everything I've been working on. Again, it's been a little bit slow. I've been really busy with dyeing, so I'm going to show all of that in the shop update. Oh, I'm so slouchy. Why? I'm going to show all of those in the shop update. And so I suppose we'll start that now. So if you don't want to see anything about shop update for tomorrow at 12:15, then I'll see you later. Have a lovely weekend and I'll catch you next week, hopefully with more crafting. Hopefully with more crafting. So shop update tomorrow, Saturday, December 10th, 12:15. There's active coupons open right now. There's always the Little Lovely coupon, which is Little Lovely, just, it doesn't matter capitals or not, it's not case sensitive, for 10% off your order. There's no minimum. I think the minimum's like 10 bucks. So it's really barely any minimum minimum of a purchase. So I have a lot of things that are still in the shop that are kind of sitting around. One of those things are these sock blanks. There's only a few left. There are 5 left. So if you're looking for some masculine colors for knitting or gifting, we have some nice blues and greens. This is the Black Lake. This is Black Family Tapestry, which is Sirius Black's tapestry. It has golds, grays, navy. Very nice masculine colors. And then for more feminine colors, we have Peeves Loves Umbrage. So for those who love electric pink, so these are electric pink with kind of like muddied up spots. So dark purples and blues and greens. Let's see if I can pull this out. I know I'm only showing you like these little bits, but these are extremely vivid, very well saturated. These come out so cool. It's almost changing the color of the screen, like when it's trying to focus. But you'll get very unique socks, kind of speckle looking socks where they might not match perfectly, but they are going to be very, very, very similar. And they'll have like a speckled type look or heathered look, depending on how much saturation there is. So you can see on the backs of the blank, it's not always as saturated as it is on the front. So you're going to get a variation in tone, which is really interesting. If you've never looked at how sock blanks knit up, one, you should check out the Yarn Hoarder the Yarn Hoarder podcast, where she does a full segment about knitting up sock blanks and what it's like. Really, you should check it out. Or you should look on Instagram, search for the hashtag sock blank, and you'll see people who have knit up socks from sock blanks. And then this one is Exploding Pink Lemonade. Again, this is a very nicely saturated pink, but this is more of a pastel, kind of a pastel pink. So it's got yellows and speckles of dark, deep, plummy pinks. Of all different values, so it would make very interesting socks. It's not just a solid color, which I really like. Now I gotta try and get this back in the sleeve so it's nice and neat when it arrives to your door. So those are still up in the shop. They're under the sock blank section. I'll probably dye up more sock blanks after the new year. I do have some that are blank to dye, but I don't think I'm gonna get to them before the new year. I'm not even sure if I'm gonna do another shop update before the new year. So, all right, so these two huge boxes that you cannot see are full of yarn. I'll show you. Look at all that yarn. Holy moly. So I am going to show you these. So some of these are items that are still in the shop, some of them, and then some of them are new additions that are coming, that are re-dyes of different colorways that if you missed out on them before, you have another chance to grab some. So I'm gonna start with some here. These I dyed yesterday. These are Happy Christmas Harry. They are golds, reds, greens, browns, all different tones. And I'll show you a little of how it was dyed. So if you're one of those folks who likes to plan out your stitching, this will pool. You can see it has blocks of color. So block of green, blocks of red, and blocks of yellow. And it's very multi-dimensional. There are lighter spots, darker spots. There's no real white spots. It's all very light. Like this is all light brown. Will you stop focusing on my face? These are all light brown. These are also light brown. So they're very nicely saturated. I've already had someone say, two of those are mine. So if you like the simple DK base and you like this color, then you might want to hop on it. But these will be up in the shop. I have 4 available. Now what to do with them? These boxes are full. Okay, those are 4 available. 2, 3, 4. So most of the new additions are going to be either sets of 4 or sets of 2, depending on what I dyed. So here is Happy Christmas Harry. This is on Sparkle Base, Sparkle Sock. So you can see all the sparkles. I didn't have this up on Sparkle, I don't think, for the original update. So if you were looking for, oh, look at that. If you were looking for a sparkle and you didn't see one or were able to get one of this color, they will be in the shop. This light is crazy today, guys. This light is crazy. Anyway, so happy Christmas, Harry. Sparkle 4 will be available. And then the last of the Happy Christmas, Harry, that will be put into the shop that also got sold out were the Everyday Sock. So this is Happy Christmas, Harry on Everyday Sock. Again, reds, greens, browns, golden yellows. These have a little bit more vivid yellow, which will knit up really nicely. I'll show you again kind of how it was dyed. So you can see these will pool or make fun little stripey bits in your socks if you're knitting, or if you're making them into a shawl, you're gonna have some really interesting variegation. Very nicely saturated colors. Tonal though, like not completely solid. Like they have lighter bits and darker bits. Like this is all light brown. We have some lighter maroons here. So it's a multi-dimensional color. And the baby's crying. Why not? Let's just add the baby crying to this whole podcast craziness. Okay. Now things, others that are still available. I still have one simple sock. This doesn't have yellow. This has more of an orange color because of the red migrating in the pan when I was making this colorway. So there should be one left in the shop on simple sock. So you can see the difference. It's just this has oranges in it instead of the yellow that it's supposed to have, but it's there. And then on bulky base, I still have 3 skeins available on bulky base. 1 or 2 skeins of this will make a nice cowl or a hat. And you can see here, this is how it will pull. This is using linen stitch and crochet. So kind of an example of what it will look like. I think it looks really festive, very Christmas feeling, very holiday season feeling. So that's all for Happy Christmas, Harry in the shop. Okay. Then in terms of peppermint swirl, we have 4. This one. Oh, we have another. Sorry, we have 2 on simple sock for Happy Christmas, Harry. Not just 1, 2. Okay. So we have 4 sparkle, 4 everyday, 2 simple sock, 4 DK, and 3 bulky. That's everything that's going to be in the shop. Some are there now, so if it's a color that you want on a certain base, you should go get it now. Or, you know, don't wait till tomorrow because they might not be there tomorrow. Okay. All right, so peppermint swirl. These are still in the shop. There are 2 skeins of simple DK left for the peppermint swirl colorway. Again, this is a pooling colorway, so if you stitch with it, it's going to pool or swirl depending on your stitch and your gauge, all of those lovely things. So I have 2 on simple DK that are still in the shop right now, so if you like it, you can grab it. And then new, this was a request from Kira. It's for you, Kira. Some peppermint swirl on sparkle. So this is the color and base. This is the color and base. Well, Mrs. Weasley, oh my gosh, I have questions coming for the shop. Okay, so this is Clarissa Beth, if you're watching this, I'll get to your question in a second. This is on sparkle base. So this is the color and base that was available in the kits that Lynn and I did. So some people were coveting this beautiful sparkle base. I think I only had 2 up aside from what was in the kits. If I even did, yeah, maybe it was 2. So I have 4 more going in the shop. So if you were on the hunt for sparkling peppermint swirl, this is here for you tomorrow, 12:15 Eastern time. Google what time is it in Boston and you'll know the time difference between me and you. 12:15, be there. Okay. Other things that are still in the shop. I still have some Jolly. I still have some Jolly on bulky base. If you saw the hat that I stitched last week, it was using one skein of Jolly and then just a bare skein of bulky. I still have four Overcast, which is this lovely gray blue tonal that is still available on Simple DK. So those are still in the shop. They're there right now. If you like them, grab them. If not, you can leave them if you want. I need to put these in the shop. These are Overcast on Everyday Sock. I have to take their photo, so I'm gonna put these aside so I remember to take their photo, because I didn't take their photo before. I still have Raindrops on Roses and Whiskers on Kittens. These are just some one-of-a-kind tonals that were created when I was dyeing last time. Sometimes I'll have these one-of-a-kind skeins. If I have a dye bath that doesn't fully exhaust, I'll use a bare skein to pull it up. Those are on Simple Sock. I have one more Fox Rising available on Simple Sock, which is a beautiful, fiery, variegated skein. So if you're working on something with some fire for the holidays, it's there on Simple Sock for you. Okay. Oh, I lied. There's one more. So there are three peppermint swirl on DK. Sorry about that. My boxes get a little bit mixed up. I have two minis left of peppermint swirl on Sparkle. So if you're looking for a little gift, if you're not keen to buy a full skein, you can grab a mini skein and maybe a couple tonal minis to go with this as a little gift for someone. Quite lovely. All right, other things that are left. The Peach Blush. This is a creamy, warm peach color. It's hard to tell the dimension as it is right here in this lighting for whatever reason. But it is, camera cut off again. This is a peach tonal. It's a very creamy, like peaches and cream type tonal, nice pastel. It's good for, you know, those who love pastel. There are folks out there who don't enjoy bold colors, who like more muted colors. It's very pretty. I've totally borked this skein. It's totally messed up. Okay, this is the sloppiest skein ever. Look at that. That's the worst skein ever. Anyway, I have two available in the shop on bulky. I also have two of these Dirigible Plums. This is also kind of a peachy color. It has notes of dark plum in there as well. So darker peach and dark plum speckled kind of throughout. And this is kind of what it looks like stitched up. So you can see it's very tonal, nice and dimensional to make your stitching interesting. And the baby's crying again. Today is not my day. Okay, and then I have one Jack Frost left on Everyday Sock. This will also kind of pool. Show you a little of how it was dyed. So we have some blue speckles, blue speckling on one side of the skein, so nice faint speckling, and then this blue tonal on the other side. So it should pool up, make fun little swirls or stripies on socks, give you some interesting effects on a shawl. So Jack Frost, there's one left. Okay, and then I do have cowls left. I only sold one cowl. Boo-boo. I'm still gonna make a donation of my own volition, but if you'd like to help in a donation to Boston Children's Hospital, you're welcome to purchase any of the cowls that are in my shop. If you're looking for a quick Christmas gift, 20% of the listing price, so whatever you purchase it at, it doesn't matter. If it's listed for $30, 20% of that is gonna go as a donation to Boston Children's Hospital for the holiday season. I'm leaving these cowls up, so you can kind of see how some of them fit. So this is the one in Dirigible Plums. very cozy feeling. If you know someone who loves cowls, they will probably be very grateful of a cowl gift. And if you don't have time to stitch them up before the holidays, then it's a perfect type of gift. So this one's a little more snug, like snuggly, like a turtleneck. So very cozy, very warm. There's pictures of the cowls just kind of laying flat in the light box, you know, the glamour shot style. And then there are pictures of me wearing each cowl so that you can see what the fit is like. So anyway, so those are still available. There are a bunch of the 9 or 10 that I put up, only one sold. Thank you, Christina, for purchasing a cowl. I hope you enjoy it, or I hope you enjoy gifting it, if you're gifting it. just trying to put all these away. There's more that's going in the shop. So on top of the stuff that's already in the shop and the new stuff, I have other items that are going in, which is this color. This color was out once before, actually, on this simple sock base. It was kind of a one-off trying to dye colorway. This is Mrs. Weasley, or Molly Weasley. So it is browns and peaches. I like peach. Apparently I like dyeing with peach. But it's browns, very vivid peaches, some cool grays, all mixed together. It's a variegated skein, so it's not, it shouldn't pool or be doing any strange effects. It's all very random, the way that it is dyed. So I will have 2 of each of these base up in the shop on Saturday. Oh my God. On Saturday. So this is on Simple Sock, Molly Weasley. Let me see. I have... Here we go. Everyday Sock. So again, we have browns and peach notes, some grays on Sparkle. Okay, and then I have it on Luxe Sock, which might be my favorite that has been dyed. And then last, but certainly not least, is on the last 2 skeins of my Luxe DK. These came out a little more gray and brown than peach, but it's definitely still peach overall. And that, my friends, is everything. I've been a busy bean, and happy to say that I'm done dying for the week. Happy to work on other things. So, Saturday, 12:15 is the shop update. It's Eastern time. If you want to find out what the difference is between your time and mine, you can always Google what time is it in Boston. I'm on the North Shore of Boston, so that's the closest you're going to get to me. Yeah. There's a Cheerio right here. Tucker's bowl of Cheerios is under this table. So anyway, I hope you guys have a lovely weekend. I am going to be busy doing these crochet hooks, taking more glamour shots of yarn, getting listings ready for tomorrow. Tomorrow, Cece has a concert, which is going to be really fun. It's like the little preschool Christmas concert. So I'm excited for that. I can't wait to see how well she does, if she likes it. She was into the fall concert a little bit, but I think she didn't really know what to expect or how long it was going to be. So by the end, she was kind of like, I'm done. So yeah, we have that Saturday at 1, which is why shop update is at 12:15. Sunday we have a birthday party to go to, and then next week is all family events and Christmas parties, and then Christmas happens. So I don't know if I'm gonna have another shop update before Christmas, but likely will hopefully be one before the new year if I can get everything squared away. But as always, have a great weekend. I will see you in my next podcast. Bye!